controversy at Galway BFM Sports Awards. MEP Ming Flanagan criticises selection process. And in other news, Age Action West praises Galway Masters football team. Good morning. The Galway BFM Sports Awards, held at the Lochray Hotel and Spa this evening, was surrounded in controversy following an incident at the hotel. There were reports of violent clashes in the bar area where Ollie Turner and Kevin Dwyer refused to pay for their round. Gardaí were called to the scene but no arrests were made. In other news, Midlands Northwest MEP Luke Ming Flanagan has criticised the selection criteria for the Galway BFM Sports Awards, where he claimed that there was insufficient representation from Roscommon. And Galway BFM News spoke to Deputy Flanagan about his concerns.
Look, I think it's an absolute disgrace that there was no representation from Roscommon at the Galway BFM Sports Awards. And I mean, I think that's just another example of rural Ireland being totally ignored by the establishment. I mean, there are footballers in Roscommon, Cathal Craig, Donny Shine and these lads, and they'd walk onto any team in Connacht in Galway or Mayo. And it was also hugely disappointing to see that the Turfcutters weren't even nominated for the Team of the Year. And again, that shows the total lack of respect for people in rural Ireland.
Galway BFM News put it to Deputy Flanagan that these awards were only for Galway residents. And Deputy Flanagan's response was swift.
Will you ever take a run and jump for yourself? You're just like the rest of the establishment.
In other news, the Galway Masters football team were praised at an award ceremony last evening hosted by Age Action West at City Hall. And Martin O'Cohen brings this report.
Inspirational, awe-inspiring and an example to others were just some of the words used to describe the achievements of the Galway Masters football team at an award ceremony by Age Action West in City Hall last evening. The organisation praised the tremendous work and the achievements of the team in securing another All-Ireland success for the county. The Masters football team were singled out for particular praise as they had shown such example to wider society to prove that the elderly can play a much wider participating role in society. The Mayor of Galway, not Pádraig Kenneally, amazingly, said that their achievements were an example to us all. For Galway BFM News, this is Martin O'Cohen in Connemara.
And now the death notices for Galway. Interest in Galway Hurling Championship. After long illness. Late of Croke Park, DRA, and formerly Galway County Board. Removal tomorrow Sunday from Mountain South Cemetery. Burial Tuesday to the Loch George pitch. Family flowers only by request. Objections if desired to the football board. Galway BFM News would like to sympathise with the family and friends of the Galway Hurling Championship. Hello and good evening, and you're very welcome to Over the Line with me, Gerry Murphy. And it's a huge night for the sports people in Galway because the Galway BFM Sports Awards are coming live from the Lochray Hotel and Spa. And without further ado, I'm going to go to Darren Kelly. Darren, you're with the Mullagh girls, still celebrating after the great County Camogie Championship victory.
Thanks, Gerry. Well, I'm still with the Mullagh girls, who haven't actually left Lochray since the county final nearly a month ago. They're making their way slowly now up to the Lochray Hotel and Spa. They haven't even been out home to Mullagh. They haven't even had a chance to change for nearly 5 weeks now since the county final. So all looking forward to getting back home, and especially looking forward to the awards ceremony where there should be a great reception for the Mullagh girls up there. So we should be up to you very shortly. Darren Kelly for Galway BFM Sport.
Okay, thanks for that, Darren. Well, it certainly sounds like that could be the party bus you're on at the moment with the Mullagh ladies. We might now go to a live traffic report. John Richards, you're out there near the Lochray Hotel and Spa. How are things looking out there at the moment?
Hi, Gerry. No major delays to report here in the hotel area. There was some earlier delays earlier in around the bar area where Kevin Dwyer or Ollie Turner were probably trying to dodge by the routes, according to one of my traffic buddies. But glad to say that things have moved on there. traffic moving quite well around the bar area. We do understand that there is a slight incident around the ladies' toilets area. We understand that there was a spillage of fake tan around the ladies' toilets, so emergency services are on their way. And from one of my traffic buddies just told me that the Gardaí are actually on the scene now, and they are directing some of the ladies into the men's toilet. So, the usual advice is just slow down. Take your time. Your journey might take a little bit longer on this particular route, but just slow down. Other than that, no major delays to report. We'll bring you one final report at the top of the hour. Back to the studio, Gerry.
Okay, thanks for that, Gerry. As they say, if you're near the bar or the ladies' toilets, approach with caution. Okay, well, we're fast running out of time on this evening's show, but we're going to go now live to George McDonagh. George, how are things hotting up out there for the punters?
Well, Gerry, thanks for that, because I can tell you something. I've never seen Leon Blanch here from Point Sports. He's a very nervous-looking man. And John Mulholland, I see him sweating buckets here in the Lochray Hotel and Spa. And it's some of the more unusual bets that are causing these guys to sweat, because there's been a few big shakers here today. Kevin Dwyer, 10-1 to line out for the Galway Masters team next year. There's been a bit of movement on that. Bernadette Prendergast from our newsroom, she assures me that nap of the day, 25-1, that Keith Finnegan will put out a free bar before the night is out. I'm not so sure, but Bernadette, you must know something we don't. On that note, Ollie Turner, he's got the same €50 note that he had from 2011, and you can get a 20-1 outside bet that he's going to split that tonight. I doubt it very much. That's a prisoner, that 50 in the back pocket, Ollie. And a few other novelty bets. Sean Walsh, our great hurling commentator, and Boyle Sports will give a free €500 bet next year if Sean doesn't call Joe Canning JC any time during the league or championship next year. Again, Boyle Sports, I think your money is safe on that one. And finally, our own Rob Murphy, 500-1, if he doesn't criticise the referee next year in the rugby. I think hell will freeze over quicker. That's all from the parade ring here at the Lochray Hotel and Spa. Back to the studio, Gerry.
Okay, thanks for that, George. Well, unfortunately, that's all we have time for this evening on Over the Line. We'll see you all, hopefully, the same time next week. From me, Gerry Murphy, have a very good evening.